The American Southwest, an ideal place for American energy.
So this part of the world is blessed with some fantastic renewable resources for generating electricity. It's really hard to get that power to market.
What do we need to bring energy to market? You need a transmission line.
That's exactly the idea behind Southline.
Southline is an innovative, high-voltage transmission project that aims to take energy from where it's generated to where it's needed in communities like El Paso and Tucson.
There's a lot of permission, permits, and agreements that have to happen to make something like Southline possible.
Naturally, this means that in order to get transmission projects built, local and federal government need to work with local communities.
Ultimately, what we're trying to do is build a line that is useful to as many stakeholders as possible. And part of that is working with the utilities in the region.
And working with people is exactly what Bill and partner Doug of Black Forest Partners decided to do.
So as you imagine, over time, Southline has been in development for over 15 years. People change, technology changes. There's a lot of change that happens.
Which is what made Christina and her team at Grid United, an independent transmission company, a great partner for Black Forest to co-develop Southline.
I believe in transmission. That's why I'm here.
From the first day that we met with Grid United a couple of years ago, they made it clear that they put communities and stakeholders first, which was refreshing and rare.
It's one of the reasons they were able to get support from the Department of Energy's Grid Deployment Office. See, GDO is making investments to improve America's electric infrastructure and helping projects move forward that have community support.
GDO support to Southline is critical in helping Southline get power to market. What that means in simpler terms is that the DOE, which really to many people means the United States government, is giving the trust and confidence in this project that it's going to serve a lot of people.
That trust is important because the Southline project has taken over 15 years, and GDO committed $470 million to help make it happen.
When you're going across two states and building more than a couple hundred miles of transmission across five counties, you run into all kinds of challenges.
Which means working with local landowners, like Edna. It's not like Southline can just start putting up transmission lines on her land.
I probably would have asked him to vacate the property.
The power line will run through her property for about half a mile.
Working with Southline has been a very positive experience. The people that I have had contact with Southline have always been up front with me, and when I have questions, they answer them.
And Edna? It's just one of the many people to work with.
There were a variety of grape growers who wanted to really create a destination for wine tasting and also hospitality, you know, setting up bed and breakfasts and hotels, and to put a transmission line through the middle of this, that wouldn't really benefit anyone. We figured that if we listened carefully, we'd come up with a overused but win-win solution. And we found that with Arizona Game and Fish.
Working together, the team developed an out-of-the-box solution to create land for the transmission line by moving Crane Lake.
I think bring that over to Homer.
Got it.
Cochise Lake is incredibly important for its biodiversity. It has over 300 species of birds that come here in migration and resident birds that utilize this area for their survival.
By moving this lake slightly to some other property, the cranes won't have to navigate any transmission lines like they do currently.
What's unique about Southline and its Crane Lake project with its stakeholders is that people have come to the table to agree together. It's one of the beautiful things that I love about infrastructure development is that it's not about opposing each other, it's about building something together.
The communication with Southline, this project, has been essential. They've been more open to communicating as well as listening and then trying to actually take action and effort to items and concerns that have been addressed.
So, as you can see, Southline was a monumental community effort in every sense of the word.
There are tons of stakeholders that we've worked with, hundreds of landowners, vineyards, engineering firms, environmental groups, game, fish and wildlife officials, utilities, power customer groups, tribal entities, and power folks. Transmission's good. We got to talk to a bunch of people to do it.
All part of finding creative ways to make projects like this possible.
Being a native of this part of the country, I think the best part of the South Line is reinvigorating the economy of the place where I grew up. I wish GDO had started the TFP and TSED programs 10 years ago. I think we would be done with this by now.
We do too, Bill. For more information on GDO and DOE's efforts to build a more resilient, affordable power grid, visit energy.gov/GDO.